ships. And now there's the two statues, the statues of the two princesses were still placed, or we say, put there. Yeah, put in the palace. And actually, last year, Hao and I, we separately went to, we traveled to Tibet. And I also went to Nepal. I found there are many, many similarities between Nepal and Tibet, especially the belief of Buddhism. This is the major animal in the Qinghai Tibet Plateau. The highest, we say Qinghai Tibet Plateau is the world roof, the world roof, the highest. And this is the railway, train railways built there. It was not easy before. Many other people, like some other countries, they didn't believe we can make it. After overcoming many challenges, and we were so determined. Finally, we successfully built the train from east part of China to Tibet. This was very important for the development of Tibet, and that's also why nowadays, so many people they are able to see to enter Tibet, or Tibet before it was separated, isolated with the rest of the world. So, but nowadays the economic conditions they are better and better. So we say in China we also have another proverb, another saying. It's like if you want to develop the economy, you build roads first. Roads are very important. This is the Potala Palace, I just mentioned, Potala Palace. In Chinese, we say Potala Gong. It's 13 floors. It has 13 floors. Okay, next part, terrain and topography of China. Actually, also, I already mentioned something. Let's see this one. This one is the distribution of mountains in China, major mountains in China. So you can see we have two